All right, I've got with me one of India's leading squash player, Padmashri, Deepika Pallikal. Deepika, you are on a sabbatical. Any specific reason?
No, I think it's just it was a conscious decision last year that post Asian Games, Commonwealth Games, and Asian Games, I was just exhausted mentally, and I was very saturated in my game as well as my ranking. So I was neither going up nor was I going down. So I wanted to take a break just to get answers, to get motivated again, get that that hungriness going and stuff. Just spend some time, which, you know, I've been on the road since I was 13 years old. Not many people know that, and I've not lived in the country since I was 13. So for me, I needed that break, and it was the right time to do that. And just sat down with my family, sat down with my coaches, and then we decided this is the best time to take that break and just reflect on what I want to do as a squash player, what I want to do with my career. And we've got answers. We're slowly getting there, but surely.
And any plans to come back to the circuit soon?
No, definitely. I think squash, I have a lot more to give in regard to my sport and in my career. And I do want to get back. The aim and the goal is to get fit for the Commonwealth Games and the Asian Games, which happens, I think, in 3 years. But I do want to get back on court. I miss the sport terribly. And I think when the time is right, I'll pick my racket back.
Deepika, you said, mentally you got fatigued. You are an international athlete. Dinesh, your husband, is also an athlete. Is it difficult? You know, he's also traveling. You are also traveling. Is that one of the reasons, perhaps, as you're saying, you've been traveling a lot. So was that a reason that you thought maybe it is time to just give some time to the family?
No, I don't think one of the many reasons was to spend time with family, but it wasn't the main reason. I think for me and for Dinesh, in that sense, I think our game always takes the front seat in our house. And I think for me, it was about decisions that I had to make about my game in general. And I wasn't satisfied with the way I was playing or the way I was feeling on court, off court. And I'm not a person to just go ahead, just take it as it comes, or, just go ahead with me playing the way I am. I wanted to try and do better. I wanted to feel better. I wanted to be happy about my game in general. So I think the decision was taken purely because of my game. It needed a break. My body, my mind, physically, mentally, everything, it just needed a break. And yes, family does play a big role, and also being married to an athlete plays an even bigger role. Dinesh is obviously on the road for the longest time, but that's not the main reason why I took the decision. But yes, it's one of the many reasons.
All right, ups and downs are part and parcel of every international or any athlete for that matter. If I ask you a question, how supportive is your husband or you towards him through these times? Would be a very cliche question, but how do you guys motivate each other? Do you have any inputs to give him? Of course, I know. I think you don't like cricket as a sport.
No, it's. I think we both try and stay away from each other's way. I think that's the right way of putting it. I think when I need advice, I call him up. When he needs advice, he calls me up. I think that's about it. We give in enough and each other space. I think we both have a brilliant team, behind us, and we have enough people to answer our questions, and when we have doubts. But it's obviously hard. I think for any athlete, especially it was very frustrating for me. To be mentally and physically not being able to get on court post the Asian Games and Commonwealth Games. But I know that Dinesh and my family have played a very big role in trying to make it as normal as it can, because being an athlete for, 17 years and suddenly not having anything to do is a thing to the system. But I think we both know that we are there for each other. I think we both know that regardless of the result, the most important thing is what we do behind the scenes. We work as hard as anyone else. The results don't come, they don't come. If they come, they come. But we've done the whole process of trying to be the best is the most important thing. So I think we know that we're there for each other, but as I said, we try and stay away from each other's way. If we need each other, we're there.
And you know, you've been very vocal as far as gender equality, especially in sports, is concerned. If I'm not wrong, you chose to boycott a national championship also in I think mid 2015, if I'm not wrong. You still feel that's the way? That's still it still exists, because has anything changed after your decision in 2015?
Well, no, it definitely has. I think after I boycotted the Nationals 1 year, the next year they did have equal pay, and they've had equal pay ever since. So, and that's why I played it the next year, was because they had equal prize money for the men and the women. Yes, there are here and there, yes, there are, you know, a few things that still need to get sorted, but I think the world is, you know, revolving around women doing really, really well, and especially not just, you know, not just supporting women, but celebrating women. And I think this is an apt brand to be associated with, and that's why I'm here talking to you, is because with Adidas, I think they don't just support women, but they celebrate us, and I think that's very important in this day and age.
One last question, because I asked this earlier also, because we've read this that you don't like cricket as a sport too much, enjoy
it. It was just taken out of context, I think.
So you do like?
The thing is that I don't enjoy watching this sport. I think especially with me, when I didn't know Dinesh, as an other athlete other than a cricketer, I think it's very difficult for us to appreciate this sport, because a lot of attention goes to the cricketers and not the other sports. So it was very difficult for me to appreciate cricket. But over the years, I've obviously I've not enjoyed it, but I've enjoyed going on field and just watching Dinesh play in general. When Dinesh is not on the field, I don't really watch cricket that much. But when he's there, I tend to try and catch up on what he does and what his team does.
So, you come from Chennai. Yes. So, is Chennai Super Kings your preferred team, or Kolkata Knight Riders?
I think you have the answer for it, sir. Wherever my husband goes, my heart goes.
All right. Yeah. All right. Thank you very much, Deepika, and all the best as you hopefully we'll see you on court soon. Yeah.